All right, good morning. The time now is 9:50. Let's have a look at weather. We're going to go with some decreasing rain this morning. I'm going to show you that on the satellite imagery because it is all starting to move out of here. Partly cloudy. It is going to stay a little humid today, and we are going to keep scattered showers and thunderstorms in the mix. Here is your radar picture, and as you can see, at the beginning of the loop, we had a significant amount of shower and thunderstorm activity moving across St. Tammany Parish and Washington Parish. All this is starting to minimize right now, move out of the area. The flash flood warning that was up has now been canceled. That was for North Central Washington Parish. That's gone as well, as most everything starts to move out of here, everything being all the rain and all the thunderstorm activity. Check out the satellite imagery because we're trying to start to clear everything out, trying to get a little more sunshine in here. I think we'll accomplish most of that. We are going to stay partly cloudy, though, unfortunately, because we do have the low-level moisture. You'll see some of these puffy clouds developing in the afternoon and those scattered showers and thunderstorms along with that daytime heating. Currently in Belle Chasse, it's 84 degrees on the North Shore, looking at 83 degrees in Folsom, and your temperatures along the Mississippi Gulf Coast are starting to warm up pretty nicely. Right now in Gulfport, 87 degrees as the sun really starts to come out. All right, so here's what's going on. Here's your forecast model. This is about 10:19 this morning. Notice all the rain. I think we're going to get a break a little bit. And then by this afternoon, like I said, the sun comes out, daytime heating. That'll fire off a few showers and thunderstorms. And then in the overnight hours, we'll get a bit of a break. But by the morning, we should see some coastal showers developing. These will start moving onshore because the flow right now is out of the south, southeast. So that'll expect that in the morning during drive time. And then in the afternoon, we'll get a little daytime heating. Once again, typical summertime pattern is what we're seeing here as the remnants of Bonnie really move on out of here. We'll start moving into what we usually and typically see this time of year. And then as we get into Tuesday, a little less coverage. Notice we still have some shower and thunderstorm activity, but less than what we're expecting today and to tomorrow. And then Tuesday and Wednesday, I'll show you on that 7-day exactcast, high pressure is going to set up, and then rain chances will be down about 20%. For today, here are your high tides and low tides for the Wrigley's Grand Isle in the Southwest Pass. Your range is just under 2 feet. For this afternoon, upper 80s, lower 90s, and your rain chance is at about 50%. We'll call it 40 to 50%. And here is your 7-day exact cast. So we'll keep the rain chances where they are right now. We'll see what happens. We may adjust this for tomorrow, but definitely by Tuesday, rain starts to decline. High pressure starts taking hold. Wednesday down to 30%. And as we get into Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, high pressure is going to set up right on top of us. Now, notice your temperatures. In response to that, as your rain chances start to decrease, your temperatures start to increase. And that's what we usually get this time of year. Looking by next weekend, mid to upper 90s, definitely a possibility. Morning lows in the meantime, you could see, are going to range basically in the upper 70s to near 80. There's your look at weather. Let's turn now and have a look at sports with Keely Fulton.
Besides getting in double digits in the win column, the 2010 edition.